Good morning, everyone. Of Digital Vivi, good old neighbor, Nikki, Confusion, Tube, and No, Thunderdog, Fans, and Unwanyo. You know. And due to MCU Phase 4, have sadly come to the end because the last Marvel Phase 4, it's had to be Black Panther Wakanda Forever, which is the greatest accrusion to the MCU Phase 4. So I'm probably people will say, ooh, Phase 4 is the worst MCU phase because they're all woke, the Mary Sue, and Kevin Feige, better be shaming yourself. Yes, I know, the May She-Hulk, I understand that. But honestly, we're not talking about She-Hulk because we are not going to talk about that ever again. Maybe on my top 10 worst shows of all time, bro, so I might do that in the future. But all the movie in this ranking is not always terrible. Well, it's not always decent. It's all great, you know? And so, hey guys, so today I'm doing my ranking on all the MCU Phase 4 movies all the way this year. And all the way 2021, all the way this year. Because MCU Phase 4, this has got to be one of my favorite phase of the MCU because they always give girl power, which honestly I don't care what Jimmy and Iron said about Marvel Phase 4 because they'll always be too hard for it. Anyway guys, so sit back and relax, grab your Marvel Phase 4 DVD, and now it's time to talk about my ranking all the MCU movie Phase 4. Now let's get started, shall we? Sorry guys, coming in the bottom, it's had to be Thor World of Thunder. Even I have fun for this movie, but it just has to be one that, honestly, I'm sorry guys, this has got to be one of my weakest other than Marvel Phase 4, because this movie was really comedy than an action adventures movie, but and this movie is a really fun movie, because honestly, I do admit, I think the story is a little bit cliche, because we see that type of story like a million times, anyway. And anyway guys, and Jane Foster is a really great character, and Thor is a really funny character, and Kurt is my number 5 favorite character in the movie. And Gore the God Butchers is honestly one of my second favorite performance I ever seen for Christian Bale. Because my number 3rd is had to be his character from Amsterdam. And honestly, my number 1, like, come on, is him as Bruce Wayne, aka Batman from the Dark Knight trilogy. Because him as Bruce Wayne, aka the Batman, will always be his best performance I ever seen from him, and honestly, in my number 4, it has to be the one character, one of the main antagonists from the American Psycho. So yeah, and so hey guys, and now one, T.S. Thompson, she's a really awesome character, and honestly, I would admit that. Honestly, people, I still have some few flaws about this movie. First of all, who in the right mind want to see Marisa Coffey as a villain for Thor and the Wog Prey? Honestly, I think that scene is easily one of the worst scenes of this movie, because it was absolutely cringe. After I saw Marisa Coffey when I went to saw this movie in theaters with my mom, and I was like, oh god, not Marisa Coffey. Honestly, I'm not a huge fan of Marisa Coffey. Her comedy movie is just like the same old bull crap, so yeah. And some comedy of the film didn't make no sense. And I think the yelling goat always get on my nerve, because at first I think it's pretty funny, but every single time you use it, and honestly, it's kind of feel like you're getting sick and tired of it, because honestly, it's kind of remind me, you're in a fireworks show, and people want to wear some fireworks, and I was like, ooh, that's pretty cool, and after you do it as a thousand times, and you'll be like, I'm tired of this. Anyway, and honestly, I did not like the character decision in this movie, because they turn him as a villain. Are you freaking kidding me? He is not a villain, because why would you do the scene when he was trying to help with Thor with the lightning bolt, kind of look like a golden, but nope, they put him as a villain, and he did not deserve to be the villain. Anyway, guys, even this movie has some few flaws, but overall, I think Thor World of Thunder is a really great movie, but I think Thor Ragnarok is a much better Thor movie than this. So, hey guys, now let's get to the other ranking, which is Ended in Eternals. Honest people, honestly, people, you need to stop hating this film, because honestly, this movie don't deserve any hatred, because honestly, this is one of the most original MCU movies I ever seen in my life, because this movie is honestly one of the most underrated comic book movie ever made, because this movie is a really awesome movie, and honestly, I do admit, I did not like that cameraman character in this movie, because he's not, because honestly, what's the point of having him in the story, so yeah. And sorry guys, and here's some comedy of the film I was not laughing, especially that one of my favorite character have her ringtone, and no joke, they actually play Tom and Jerry music, Tom and Jerry trailer music, no, not the older one, I'm talking about the 2021, like this, oh my goodness, I hate that song, that's honestly one of the worst song I ever seen for Tom and Jerry trailer music. And sorry guys, even the Tom and Jerry trailer is not as, it's not good, but the movie is shockingly pretty good. And sorry guys, the action scene, it looked fantastic. The story is really original, because this is honestly one of the most, different MCU movie, because this is not your typical MCU like the Avengers, Doctor Strange, and etc. No, this movie is like the, it's like the original MCU, so I just want to give a round of applause to Kevin Feige. So again, this is the very first MCU movie it has a rotten rating. Are you freaking kidding me? So are you telling me this movie is way worse than Captain Marvel, Thor the Dark War, and Iron Man 2, more Iron Crap 2 and Iron Crappy 2? No. Captain Marvel is way worse than Eternals, and Captain Marvel deserve like a rotten rating, not a freaking fresh rating. What the frick is wrong with you? Anyway, guys, and that's why Eternals is in the Netter ranking. And honestly, let's get to the Netter ranking. This has to be the Black Widow. Honestly, I don't understand why some people think this movie woke. People, you need to stop saying woke. Woke is really freaking annoying sometimes. Anyway, even I have some few flaws about the movie, like two villains. What's the point of having two villains in the movie? And honestly, not one villain is kind of remind me of Bill from Violet First, but you place him with the glasses and you shave his beard. Yeah, it's kind of remind me of that. And anyway, even this movie has some one flaws, it has to be the villain. But overall, I think this film is a PG-13 version of John Wick. And sorry guys, my favorite character of the film, it had to be Yadis, which is Black Widow's sister. I always have a crush on her, and she will always be my favorite female character crush of the MCU, because she is such a beauty. And her actress is the main reason why I check out Don't Worry Darling and all of her film, like Little Woman and etc. on Christmas last year. And sorry guys, and that's why Black Widow is honestly one of my favorite, Scarlett Johansson movie I ever seen, because Black Widow was really beautiful. And Red Guardians, honestly, is it just me, but Red Guardians kind of remind me of my friend Buzz. Yeah, honestly guys, his actor is kind of remind me of Buzz. Honestly, they have a face, they have the same face expression, they have the same beard, and they have the same accents. So yeah, and sorry guys, and honestly, that's pretty cool, because I like Red Guardian, because he's a really awesome character next to his character from Stranger Things. And sorry guys, that's why Black Widow is in the Netter ranking. And sorry guys, and honestly, let's get in the Netter ranking, shall we? Sorry guys, coming to Netter ranking, it's had to be Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. Honestly, I don't understand why some people think this movie is the most forgotten MCU movie ever, because back in September 3rd, when this movie came out, this movie was a golden phenomenon, but this movie called it, but honestly, some people sadly hate the film, called this movie racist, and called it what's the point of having Asian superhero movie. Okay, honestly, that is completely racist, you know that. But this year, when this movie, a lot of people forgot this movie even it exists. Are you kidding me right now? Having not seen this movie is for $9, which is at Walmart, you can just go buy it. And so, you guys, have you not seen on Disney Plus? On Disney Plus Day, they released the movie, and you just didn't bother watching it? Oh my goodness, I feel bad for this movie, man. But overall, I think it's honestly one of my favorite Asian movies I've ever seen, because this movie is a fantastic movie with a fantastic story, fantastic character, fantastic. And Wong is a really awesome character. Chen Qi is a really awesome character. And the one actress she was in, Wang as Dragon, and the bad guy is as a spider character. I forgot her name. It's like Trindisia, I don't know. And sorry, guys, and the villain of the film is really fantastic. And this movie is a global phenomenon, and this is honestly one of my favorite September movie ever in 2021. This movie is a way better September movie than that god-awful cinema of 2021, which honestly, I don't want to talk about that movie. That is honestly one of the worst movies I've ever seen in my life. Sorry, guys, and that's why Chen Qi and the Legend of the Teen Rain is in my ranking. So let's get to another one. And sorry, guys, get ready for your multiverse and get ready to crawl the multiverse. Honestly, coming in at a ranking, which is other than Doctor Strange 2 and the Multiverse of Madness, or you can call it Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, whatever you call it. Anyway, this is honestly one of my favorite horror film I ever seen in my life, and this is honestly one of my third favorite comic book movie ever made, next to Wakanda Forever and No Way Home. Anyway, this movie is a really scary movie, but in a good way, because Kevin Feige and MCU did a really fantastic job to bring this movie to life. Honestly, I don't understand why some people think this. Honestly, the hate of this movie is completely uncalled for, because honestly, you know why they hate the film? It's because they did not like the fact that they turned Scarlet Witch as the villain. Have you not even read a comic book? Have you not even watched WandaVision? If you do, so why in the world you hate this film just because Scarlet Witch is a terrible villain? No. She's honestly one of my favorite villains of the MCU. Yeah, she's way better than Thanos. Even I like Thanos. Because if I say love, because that's kind of my, honestly, it's kind of my Miyagi people. And sorry, guys, and this movie is a really fantastic horror movie. And Samuel, you did a really good job to make this movie and bring this movie to life. Anyway, guys, I cannot wait to rewatch it again and again and again and again, just like No Time to Die and Frozen 2, because this is only one of the most rewatchable MCU movie ever made. And sorry, guys, and shocking enough, I have not rewatched The Avengers Endgame yet, because, like, come on, it's a freaking 3-hour movie. So do you honestly think I will rewatch 3-hour movies? No, nada. This is the main reason why I have not seen The Green Mile, because The Green Mile is like 3-hour long movies. So yeah. And sorry, guys, and that's why Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness is in the nether ranking. So let's get to another one, shall we? And sorry, guys, coming in number 2. Oh, wait a minute. Coming in number 2? Yeah. Coming in number 2, which is other than Black Panther Wakanda Forever, which is the movie I went to saw yesterday. Honestly, this is honestly one of my favorite comic book movie of the year, and this is honestly one of my favorite movie of the year, because this movie is very emotional. The villain is really shocking good, and honestly, in the death scene of the queen, which honestly, if you haven't seen the film, I recommend you X the video out. I'm just going to give one spoiler of this movie. So yeah, there was a scene when the villain grabbed a bomb, which is a bomb of water, and throw it. And they kill off the queen. That's right, they kill off the queen, do you hear me? And so, you guys, they are trying their best to wake the queen up, but thank God Ironheart did survive, for there's a one killer that did not survive, which is none other than the queen. And I feel so bad for Sushu, because honestly, the main character of the film was really crying that the queen died and at the Fiend Wall, and they are really upset. So yeah, guys, and rest in peace to the queen, because queen did not deserve to die. So yeah, and so yeah, guys, first it was a passing of Chadwick Boseman, and now the queen in Black Panther Wakanda Forever is in heaven now. And sorry, guys, Wakanda Forever, I love this movie, and I cannot wait till we watch it again and again and again in 2023. And sorry, guys, I'm probably just coming on Disney Plus maybe next year, because I cannot wait that long, because I might watch it again on 123 movie, because that's a legal website. Yeah, Fuki Bob is right. 123 movie is a really legal website, and they should be banned. And so again, this is honestly one of my favorite movie of the year, and this is honestly one of my favorite comic book movie of the year, because the only comic book movie I have never seen this year, which is other than Black Adam. Yes, people, I have not seen Black Adam, but I might watch it this. Honestly, I might watch it today because I have not seen that movie in theater. But Marcus say and not take me to go see Black Adam. So you guys, and thank God he take me to see Wakanda Forever, which is the one movie I really need to see. But thank God I went to saw it. So you guys, and that's why Black Panther Wakanda Forever is in my number two. Now let's get to number one. There is no MCU Phase 4 will be in the number one way better than Wakanda Forever, Doctor Strange 2, Black Adam, Shang-Chi, Eternals, and Love and Thunder. The best MCU Phase 4 has to be Spider-Man No Way Home. The main reason why I'm using a extended edition poster than the original poster, and just deal with it. So hey guys, Spider-Man No Way Home, this is honestly one of these greatest comic book movie ever made. And this is honestly one of my favorite Spider-Man movie I have ever seen in my life. The story is really good, and the characters are really well written. And Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield chilling is a really, really, really pretty good and really nostalgia, because I like Tobey Maguire and I kind of like Andrew Garfield because I used to hate him in the first The Amazing Spider-Man back in 2012, and now after The Amazing Spider-Man 2 in this movie, I now like Andrew Garfield as Spider-Man. So yeah, and Doctor Strange is a really awesome character, and my favorite character of the film, it's MJ. What do you expect? It's honestly one of my favorite performances I've ever seen from Zendaya. And the action scene of the film, is really fantastic. Like the Dr. Octopus action scene, and the climax, and Green Goblin versus Spider-Man, which is Tom Holland's Spider-Man, because Tom Holland was trying to kill off Green Goblin, and thank God Tobey Maguire stopped him, because we don't want Green Goblin to die. So yeah. And this movie has some greatest experience I have ever seen, because when I saw this movie at the early screening, a lot of my audience was cheering every single thing. Like the Daredevil, like the villain, the douche, and one of my favorite cheering is had to be my audience cheering of Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield. I will never forget. That screening is way better than my Frozen 2 screening, because my Frozen 2 screening, even that movie is a masterpiece, but my screening was really whackbuster because people didn't even chill, didn't be happy. There was dead silence. After the movie's over, they walk out. What the heck? And sorry guys, and Spider-Man No Way Home, I'm just going to say, Spider-Man No Way Home is my number one favorite Marvel Phase 4, and everyone will definitely agree with me. Well, goodbye to Marvel Phase 4. Great for the fun journey. And I really hate to doing this, but I'm just going to delete the poster. So you guys, and so yeah. Yeah, say goodbye to MCU Phase 4. Love and Thunder, Eternals, Black Widow, Shang-Chi, Doctor Strange 2, Wakanda Forever, and Spider-Man No Way Home will always be the fun memories. So yeah, that was my ranking on Marvel Phase 4. I'm very sorry I deleted the poster because I don't want my strong city to get expected. And Wakanda Forever is the last superhero movie of 2022, because there was no upcoming superhero movie this year until next year. Because I'm probably next year we're going to get Shazam 2, Spider-Verse, and all the MCU upcoming movie. And honestly, next year it's going to be the biggest year for DCEU, because thank God the DCU, which I do not like that, but I'm just going to call it the DCEU. Yeah, I'm probably the DCEU will be the biggest year for the movies, because we got Shazam 2, we got Aquaman 2, we got The Flash, and we got Blue Beetle. So yeah. And sorry guys, I don't know what the heck it Blue Beetle is, so I might watch it and see how good it is, you know. And sorry guys, I'm still not excited for The Flash, because I think The Flash is looking like a Spider-Man No Way Home whip-off, but I'm playing Kevin Feige, is going to fix this, so I always trust David Zaslav, because even he canceled the Fantastic Beasts movie, which I need to do a video of that, so yeah. And so, guys, tell me what you're ranking on Marvel Phase 4 on the comment section below. First, we did a Marvel show ranking, and now we did the movies. There was no upcoming MCU, because the last MCU we're going to get this year, which is another thing, Guardians of the Galaxy, the holiday special. So let's hope it would be way better than that god-awful Star Wars holiday special. F that special. That special will kiss my butt out right here. And so, hey guys, if you like this Marvel Phase 4 video, please, I recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn the notification, and share this video with the whole family. And if honestly, if you don't like this ranking, I recommend you go watch Frozen ranking on Marvel Phase 4, because this is, honestly, it's just like the same ranking, but he have a good point of his dialogue in that ranking. And so, hey guys. I see you next time. And so long in Peachy Tooth. Have a good day, everyone. Stay tuned for my movie review of Black Adam, because I'm going to watch Black Adam on HG Today CC, because there was no way in the white mind I will wait in 2023. Yeah, I'm not going to wait that long for Black Adam movie. Darn it. Come on, man. So, hey, guys. Have a great morning, everyone. And I see you guys later on afternoon. And I see you guys next time.